preaching, amen. I love preaching, hard preaching, soft preaching, any kind of preaching.
Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with
crucified,
him, that the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we should not serve sin. Yes. For he that is dead is free
freed
from sin.
Amen.
And at that moment, I said, you're crucified. And at that moment, there was a freedom I never had in my life.
Amen.
I had the outward holiness. I was outwardly right before God, but I had inward lust. I had inward bitterness, I had inward jealousy, and I was free from that by the cross of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus.
Come on.
And I'm going to show you by the scriptures why.
Yes, sir.
God wants to bring revival.
Yes, sir.
The Bible says in Luke chapter 11, verse 1, and it came to pass as he was praying in a certain place, when he ceased, one of his disciples said unto him, Lord, teach us to pray as John also taught his disciples. And he said unto them, when ye pray, say, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in heaven so as in earth. God says that we ought to pray for God's will to be done on earth just as it is in heaven.
Yeah.
How is it in heaven? Are there any rebellious angels in heaven? Is there any sin in heaven?
No.
Well, God says that we ought to pray for things to be done on earth just as it is in heaven.
Amen.
God says that he wants earth to be like heaven.
Yeah.
He wants the earth to be with men and women living free from sin the same way on earth.
Amen.
God says his will in 2 Peter chapter 3 verse 9. He said the Lord is not slack concerning his promise,
right,
but is long-suffering towards usward, not willing that any shall perish,
right,
but all come to repentance.
Yes.
God is not willing that no one go to hell, but everyone go to heaven.
Amen.
Well, why is this earth free from sin? Why is this earth filled with sin? Why is there so much pornography?
Yeah.
So much homosexuality.
Right.
So much drunkenness.
Right.
So much materialism.
Amen.
So many false religions.
Yes.
The reason why is because of us.
Yeah. Yeah.
The Bible says he tells us to pray.
Amen.
Thy will be done.
Yeah.
Yes.
If God could do it, it would have been done already.
Yeah.
He wouldn't tell us to pray something that couldn't happen. He doesn't waste time. He says, pray for his will to be done in earth just as it is in heaven. Give us day by day our daily bread and forgive us our sins. For we also forgive everyone that is indebted to us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And he said unto them, he's still teaching on prayer. Which of you shall have a friend, and shall go unto him at midnight, and say unto him, Friend, lend me three loaves, for a friend of mine is in his journey, is come to me, and I have nothing to set before him. And he from within shall answer and say, Trouble me not, the door is now shut, and my children are with me in bed. I cannot rise and give thee. I say unto you, though he will not rise and give him, because he is his friend, yet because of his importunity, he will rise and give him as many as he needeth.
Hallelujah.
In this parable, someone has a need.
Yes.
Yeah.
There's a man, and he has a friend that's coming to him in his journey.
That's right.
And he wants to set some food before this man. But it's at midnight. It's late.
Yeah.
The kids are asleep. Now, I travel on the road with Michael and Tamika, and they have two children, Paul and Anna, and I know how it is. When it's midnight, the children are asleep. You don't want to bother the children when they're asleep.
Amen.
Amen.
That would be the wrong thing to do. Now, this person could have had a couple options. He could have waited till the morning and then say, okay, well, once the kids are woken up, Once you have everything ready, when it's a convenient time for you, then I'll ask you for the bread. But this person didn't have that attitude. Yes. He said, no, I need it right now.
Yes.
I need it right now. Right. He said, because of his importunity.
Right. Yes.
That means persistent request.
Yes. Yes.
That means a bold and a frank request.
Yes.
That means something that's impolite.
Yes.
It would seem to come to God at this time and say, God, I want revival. God, I want soul saved. God, I want you to do the same thing you did in Acts. Yeah, it may seem like it's the wrong thing to tell God. How can I bother God? He's about to come back. Jesus is about to come back and take his church. It's a bad time. Homosexuality is worse than it ever was.
Yeah, yeah.
The world is so bad now. The Antichrist has taken over. Yeah. But no, he said, because of your importunity.
Yeah.
When's the last time you came to God with a request for his souls?
Yeah.
And you were persistent,
yeah,
unmoving,
yeah,
unshaken, yeah, saying, God, I want souls.
Yes.
Give them to me now.
Mm.
That's why your prayer isn't answered. That's why there's no revival. Because you don't want it bad enough.
Hallelujah.
If you wanted it, you have it.
Amen.
He goes on to say, ask and it shall be given to you. Ask how? Ask with importunity. What if it were your children that were lost?
Come on.
How would you ask God then? How would you ask God then? What if it was your wife that was lost? How would you ask God then? How would you go before the Son of God? Would you say, oh God, just save them? I hope you find them. Then go on about your business. Never!
Yeah.
The Bible says, ask and it shall be given unto you.
Yeah.
If you ask with importunity. If you ask like you're desperate.
Yeah.
If you ask like you really want to receive it.
Yeah.
The Bible says, seek and you shall find. The Bible says in Luke chapter 19, Jesus Christ came to seek and save that which was lost.
Amen.
Are you seeking the lost like you really want to find them? Are you out there preaching as if this was the last day? As if Jesus Christ would come back?
Amen.
Are you warning them?
Amen.
Saying you got to get saved today. The Bible says, as in the days of Noah, so shall it be the Son of Man.
Amen.
They were eating. They were drinking. They were planning and building.
Yes.
Until the day Noah stepped into that boat.
Yeah.
Let me tell you, the same days and the way they are right now, people are still eating and drinking.
Yeah.
People are still building and planning.
Yeah.
Jesus could come back tonight.
Tonight.
Is your sermon a comeback tonight sermon? Mm. The Bible says, knock, and the door shall be opened unto you. Do you knock on the door of these sinners' hearts, believing that it'll be open? The Bible says without faith it's impossible to please God.
That's right.
So you have to ask, believing you're receiving.
Amen.
That means prayer, believing, prevailing prayer comes before preaching.
Yes.
That's right.
That means before you go out and preach, you pray. And you believe that you receive their salvation. Before you go out, then you go out and seek. Believing you'll find one to be saved. And you knock, believing that that door will be open unto you. That they'll open up their hearts and receive Christ. The Bible says that is the way that you'll have answered prayer.
Yeah.
That is the way that revival will come to your life, to the lives of those in the city, and the lives of those in the world.
Amen, brother.
Amen.